Hello dear children, today in this class I am going to explain you about story writing from lesson 34. Story writing is a form of composition where an outline will be given and then you have to compose your story by giving your thoughts and ideas to the outline. You have done a little bit of practice in your previous class, in class 3 also. So it is not a new topic for you all. I know some of you can do it very well. So without any delay, let's get started. Now first, what is a story? A story is a tale that is made up for entertainment. It is a telling of a happening or a series of happenings, whether true or fictitious. What is the meaning of fictitious? Not real or true. Now, what is a story? It is a story is something that is made up for entertainment. All right. It is a telling of happening. What is happening now? What is going to happen later on? Or what has happened already? All these happenings are told as a story. You see a movie and then you read a story books, then you see that one after another something is happening all the time, right? So it is a telling of a happening or a series of happening. It may be a one happening or it may be a series of happening, whether true or false. Now let's look at the outline of the story. This I have given to explain you just for an example. An ant is weary and thirsty dash walks along the bank of a river dash stops to quench thirst dash strong rush of water dash carries away dash drowning the ant dash dove on a tree dash plucks a leaf dash floats safely to the bank dash thanks the dove dash a bird catcher under the tree dash lays lime twigs dash makes a trap to catch the dove dash ant stings his foot dash bird catcher cries in pain dash throws the twig dash noise draws at dove's attention dash dove flies away. So this is the outline of a story. And I am very sure that all of you are familiar with this story. You have heard about this story before also. We will discuss about this story in the next page. First, you see, note, the outline describes a sequence of events with characters in the form of points and phrases. And we must give life to these outline into a complete story. Now, you have to remember that some sentence is given and then dash is there and again another sentence. So these sentences one after another is given in the form of points. You can say an ant is weary and thirsty. This is point number one. Walks along the bank of a river. Point number two. Stops to quench thirst. Point number three. Strong rush of water, point number four. Okay, these events are given in the form of points and we must give life to this outline. Now this outline is lifeless. You are going to give life to this outline to form a complete story. Now what do you need for story writing? First, characters of the story. The characters in the story may be people, animals, and sometimes even non-living things who talk and behave like human beings. Okay, characters, the meaning of character mean person or people. Okay, the characters in the story may be people. Okay, it may be an animal also, or it may be a non-living thing. You have seen many stories and rhymes in the smart board. Even the non-living things starts talking, right? Even the animals also, they talk. So the characters, that means the people or the person in the story, may not always be a human being. It may be an animal or a non-living thing also, and they talk and behave like human beings. Now, how to develop a story from an outline? Okay, 10 points are there. How to write a story? How to develop a story from an outline means how you will write a meaningful story from a given outline. Number one, read the outline of the story carefully and understand what the story is all about. First, you have to read the outline. Read again and again. If at first you don't understand, then read the second time. Okay? Or else you read for the third time or the fourth time. Read it properly and then understand what the story is all about. Develop the points of the outline into complete sentence. Now, the points are incomplete. The phrases or the point that is given in the outline, you can see in this example, an ant is very and thirsty. This is in something incomplete. This is not complete. So you have to add some more words or some more sentences to make the point meaningful. Second one is walks along the bank of a river. Now, who walks, what happened at the bank of the river, nothing is mentioned. So you have to add some phrases or some words to complete the points. Number two is develop the points of the outline into complete sentence. Try to understand this. Okay. Number three, follow the outline of the story. A is follow the sequence in which the points are given. These points form the series of events in the story. What you have to do? You have to follow the sequence. Here, if the first point is an ant is weary and thirsty, this is the first point. Second point is walk along the bank of a river. Now, you cannot mix one first point. After writing first point, you cannot write the third point. Or after writing second point, you cannot write the eighth point. You have to follow this point. At first, point number one, then point two, then point three. You cannot avoid this sequence. You have to write serially. Do not omit any part of the sentence. Look at number B. Do not omit. Omit means do not exclude. Okay? Do not miss any part of the sentence. Whatever is given in the outline, you have to mention about those lines in details. Number C, do not include any unrelated or unnecessary events that may change the story completely. Now, whatever is given in the outline, you have to make a story only with the help of those points. Don't bring any points of your own. If you do this, what will happen? The story will change completely. Don't change the line of the story. Point number four. Every story has a beginning, middle, and ending. Okay, you have to start. Maybe in the library period you have read some story books where you have a beginning and then middle and then ending. How do you start a story? For example, once upon a time there was a woodcutter. You start like this? Yes. So there should be a proper beginning. And then you have to write the main story, what it is all about, in the middle portion. And then you have to close the story also. You should give a proper ending. understood. Point number one, you should read the story carefully and understand what the story is all about. You should develop the points of the outline into complete sentence. The points that are given are not complete. Okay, you have to make it into complete sentence by adding phrases. Number three, follow the outline of the story. What you have here, A, B and C, you have to follow point after points. Don't write the first point and then the tenth point. After 1, 2, then 3, then 4. You have to write the story like that. Do not omit, do not exclude or do not miss any part of the sentence. And do not include any unrelated or unnecessary events. If anything that is not related to the story, do not include those points also. Because if you are going to include, then what will happen? You will change the storyline completely. Now, every story has a beginning, middle and ending. Point number five, include details to make the story interesting and enjoyable to read. So you have to write the story in details. Don't just write for the sake of writing. Okay, you have to write everything in detail. If you are writing about an ant, write about the ant in detail. Whatever is there, what he is doing, what it is doing, what it is eating, etc., etc. Okay, and make the story interesting and enjoyable to read. Now, who will read your story? Your teacher is going to read the story, right? So when you write the story, write in such a way that when the person who is reading your story will be able to understand the story very easily. Okay, now when your teacher explains you the story, then you are able to understand, yes or no? So in the same way, when you are writing, write in such a way that your teacher also will be able to understand what you are writing. Number six, write the story in past tense, even if the outline may be provided in present tense. Okay, write the story in past tense. You all know what is past tense? The thing that has already happened. Okay, even if the outline is given in present tense. I will tell you in the next page. Number seven, introduce dialogue or conversation to make the story engaging. Now you can add dialogues or conversation also. You all know what is dialogue, right? Or conversation. Like, for example, the ant looked up at the dove and said, "Thank you for saving my life. I am very grateful to you." Now this sentence, which is inside quotation mark, "Thank you for saving life," this is the dialogue of the ant. This is the direct speech said by the ant to the dove. You can introduce dialogues also, like this type of dialogues, like "Thank you for saving my life. I am grateful to you." Number eight, choose a title that is related to the main characters or events of the story. Now, the outline that I have given is a story related to the ant and the dove. They are the main characters, right? So you have to choose a title that is related to the main characters, that means main people. What is the meaning of characters here? People or person. You have to see who is the main person of the story, right? So you have to choose a title that is related to the main characters or events of the story. What is happening in the story? If that event is important, then you can give the name of that event also. For example, if there are many characters in a story and we are talking about a festival, Holi. So you can write, you can give a title according to the events also, like simply you can write Holi, my favorite festival Holi, like this. Okay, if there are no main characters. Number nine, write the title using title casing in which the main words begin with capital letters. For example, the ant and the dove. what is title casing. You have done in computer like upper case and lower case. Upper case is capital letters and lower case is small letters. So write the title using title casing. That means if you are naming the title of the story by giving the name of the main characters, then those main characters name should start with capital letter. Okay, they falls under proper noun at that time. For example, the ant and the dove. The here T is in capital letter. Why? Because it is the beginning of the sentence. Then the main characters are ant and dove. Ant A should be in capital and here D should be in capital. Rest of the words are not necessary to write in capital. Did you understand? The ant and the dove. Why T is in capital? Because it is the beginning of the sentence. A is in capital because ant is the main character, and D is in capital because D is also the main, dove is also the main character. If you are writing, if you are giving the title of the story by the event name, then that should also be in capital letter. Number 10, avoid the use of quotation marks and punctuation marks in the title unless it is a sentence. Now you should avoid quotation mark, double inverted commas, comma, you have to avoid them, and other punctuation mark like question mark, exclamation sign, comma, full stop, semicolon. You all know what are the punctuation marks. All these punctuation marks should not be in the title unless it is a sentence. You are supposed to use punctuation mark only in a sentence. All right. Now I have given the outline of a story in the first page, and you see here in bold letters I have written introduction, beginning, middle and ending. So your story should have a proper beginning, middle and ending. Here the story goes like this. On hot summer day, an ant was walking along the bank of a river to have a drink of water. The rush of water in the river was strong and the ant got carried away. This is the introduction. Now what happened after this? That you are going to write it in a right in the middle portion, and don't worry that by thinking that you have to complete it within one or two paragraph, you can extend the paragraphs also into 3 to 4 paragraphs. Like a dove was sitting on a tree. Was is in present tense. If the outline is given in the present tense, you are supposed to write the story only in the past tense. See, it is already written here, a dove was sitting. By the word was, we come to know that this is in past tense. On the tree overhead, saw the ant was drowning, so the dove plucked a leaf from a branch and let it fall into the river close to the ant. Full stop. The dove said to the ant, climb onto the leaf. I have told you that in point number 7, introduce dialogue or conversation. So see here in the middle portion, second line, climb onto the leaf. It is inside quotation mark. It will keep you from drowning and you can float safely to the bank of the river, quotation mark closed. So this is a dialogue set by the dove. Okay, the ant climbed onto the leaf and floated safely. Climbed and floated is in past tense. Safely to the bank of the river. The ant was grateful to the dove and said, thank you for saving my life. Again, dialogue is there. Thank you for saving my life. Later that day, the ant saw a bird catcher. The bird catcher came and stood under the tree. He laid lime twigs and was making a trap to catch the dove. The ant realized that the bird catcher was trying to lay a trap to catch its friend, the dove. So the ant stung the bird catcher on the leg. The bird catcher let out a painful yelp and threw down the twigs. The dove heard the noise and flew away. So the middle portion is completed and ending is, so in this way the ant repaid the dove by saving its life from danger. So the three portion, introduction, middle and ending, should be written very carefully. Okay, you see the story is in past tense, there are dialogues also. And what is the title of the story? The title of the story is point number 9, you see, the ant and the dove. It is written in capital letter. What is written in capital letter? The main characters, ant and dove, right? So this is just an explanation. Do not write this explanation in your copy. Okay, you just see the video again and again for better understanding. In the next class, after completing the syllabus, we will do some practice work for story writing also. So keep on watching the video. Thank you.